The timeline is the main editing tool for video editing. You can drag and drop various media files into the different tracks for editing, such as videos, images, and music. A single track consists of a video track and an audio track. In PowerDirector, the default order of the timeline is bottom-up. For example, on the screen, you can see that the image material on the bottom track is layered over the video material on the middle track. However, if the image is moved to the top track, it will be covered by the video. This is because the timeline follows a bottom-up order, where the lower tracks overlay the upper ones. If you want to change the default timeline order, click the gear icon in the top right corner to open the Preferences interface. In the Preferences interface, click Editing on the left side, then tick the Reverse Timeline Track Order option. This will change the timeline to a top-down order logic. To add a new track, you can click the button in the upper left-hand corner. To delete a track, you can right-click on the track to open the menu for deletion. If you want to change the order of the current track, you can select the track and then drag it to rearrange. Clicking on the eye icon or audio icon will disable the video or audio on the track. For example, if you click the eye icon of this image track, you will find that the image on this track has been disabled and will not display during output. The lock icon next to it can be used to lock the track. Once locked, the media within the track cannot be moved or edited, preventing accidental changes to parts that have already been finalized during editing. Here, you can move your mouse to the edge of the interface and drag it to the right to expand. You can rename the track, making your timeline clearer. Next, let's look at how to adjust the ruler size of the timeline. Move the mouse to the ruler position at the top, and when the cursor changes to a clock icon, hold down the left mouse button and drag it left or right to zoom the ruler in or out. You can also use the timeline ruler slider located in the lower left corner to manually adjust the size of the timeline. If you want to quickly preview the entire video, click on the View Entire Video button to automatically adjust and display the timeline area based on the current project. By adjusting the ruler size, you can view and edit the media on the timeline more accurately or get a clear overview of the overall structure, helping you better understand the arrangement of the media. If you want to adjust the height of the tracks, you can double-click the track or drag it directly to achieve the desired height. Above the timeline is the toolbar, which contains some basic editing functions and advanced functions. Clicking the button on the far right allows you to customize the toolbar, making it easier to access frequently used functions.